Hi, and a very good day. So in this tutorial today, we would like to see how to get started with the CODESYS and EdgeBox RPI 200. So without further ado, let's get started. First of all, what is CODESYS? CODESYS is a development and runtime system used for programming and controlling industrial automation devices and systems. Secondly, it is a popular software platform for the development of programmable logic controllers and other automation devices. And thirdly, it is widely used in various industries, including manufacturing, energy, transportation, and building automation. Now, let's get started. First, let's look at the hardware part. For the hardware, we'll be using the previously set up hardware, whereby we'll be powering up the EdgeBox RPI 200 as per the previous tutorial. And that's about the hardware. There's not much more to talk about the hardware. And mainly, we'll be focusing on the software. So for the software, now let's get started. First of all, we need to install the CODESYS software. For that, go to the Google and type CODESYS and click the first one, CODESYS group, and go under here, go to the CODESYS store. Right here, you have the option to download the CODESYS either in a 32-bit or a 64-bit form. So depend on your working system, choose the which one is appropriate for your system. So in my case, I'm using a 64-bit and I already download and install it. So I'm not going to show the process here. Anyway, the installation and downloading process is pretty much straightforward. So there's no any trick or tricks there. So it's pretty much straightforward. Now let's, I would like to open the CODESYS which I already installed. Right, so let's open the CODESYS now. Right, so this is the CODESYS window. This is how it will look like once you open it up. So first, we need to do a few things before we can start to do build the project here or tutorial. So first, go to the tools and go to the CODESYS installer. So the window CODESYS installer window will open up. And we go to the browse and type in the search window, type Raspberry and click enter. So it will show up what are the Raspberry add-ons you can install. So just click the first one and click the install button. So in my case, I already installed it previously, so that's why it's showing the package which should be installed are already installed in the target installation. So I can show it here as well. So the installation is very straightforward. I already shown it in the tutorial page, so you can refer it to it later. So now we can close it up and we can start. The next step that we need to do is we need to connect our Raspberry Pi. For that, go to the tools and update Raspberry Pi. And here, we will key in the necessary information before we can connect. So the login credential, the username is Pi and the password is Raspberry. And for the IP, if you are not sure what is our IP, then click the scan button and it will come up here. Then you can just click this button and you can click OK. So that will be the IP address. And for the running time package, we choose the 4.8.0.0 and we click the install button. So if you open up the window message down here, so we can see what is happening actually. So these are the few things that's happening at the background. So for the configure runtime, so we will choose the multi-core. Okay, so it's selected and just click OK. So we can open it up and okay, so retrieving architecture from package management and it's a standard output ARMF. So just leave it. So just want to minimize that one. Alright, and if you want to sure that our system is already running, just click the start button and we go back to the messages here. You can see that CODESYS control already running. So now we are confident that our system is running. So the next step is we want to create a sample project. So for that, we just click the new project here. Just open up, make sure it's in the projects and it's in a standard project, and we can give it a name as LED. So just click OK. So since I already have a file here, so it's going to be, I want to override it, so just click yes. Okay, on the standard project, make sure the device you are choosing is the CODESYS control for Raspberry Pi MCSL and CODESYS GmbH. So you have another option also here, so make sure the one you are choosing is the Pi MCSL, not the other one. And for the PLC program in, so make sure you're using the ladder diagram as well, not the other one. Right, then that just click OK. And we can go to the devices here. Oh, it's not coming up because we need to configure first. Okay, now it's configured, I believe. Okay, so this is how the devices will look like once you already install the Raspberry Pi and everything. And in here, now we want to configure the GPIO. So for that, for the GPIO, what we want to do is we want to click the devices and right click on that and click add device. In the add device, go to the miscellaneous drop down and click the GPIO and click add device. And next, once the GPIO is appearing on here, right click here as well and click add device. No need to add device since already open the window here. Just click on the GPIO and choose the GPIO's 1 bit. So since we are using the 1 bit only, just click 1 bit and click add device. So it's already been added, so we can close this window. And before we move further, make sure to delete the GPIOs A and B because it will be interfering with our other GPIO. So just click delete. So once it deleted, now go to the GPIOs 1 bit and double click on that and come to the configuration. So this is a GPIO system FS module parameters. So here we want to do some few configuration here. So first of all, this one should be the output. And the GPIO pin number should be 21. This is as per the datasheet. This is where the LED2 is connected to. And for the active load, we can just remain it here. Next, we want to go to the GPIO module input output mapping. So here, what we want to do is we want to name it as LED input. And the other, for the other one, the out channel out, we want to do that LED underscore, we want to do output. Alright. So now with this, we have reconfigured our GPIO. Next, what we want to do is we want to configure the our devices communication. So for that, we double click the device. Just double click. So we're going to go to the communication settings. And in here, go to the device. Go to option. Go to manage favorite devices. And choose the IP address here. This is the our IP address here. But if you are using a different IP address, so just click the... So for the IP address, just click the add button here and key in the IP address accordingly and click OK. So since mine already here in the favorite, so I'm just going to click the add the IP address and click the OK button. And once I already added, I just go here and choose the IP address. And okay, since I need to have a login here, so just key in your credential here, password, then click OK. So now we can view the device details here. Basically, the device details here. So once you have your details here, now make sure it's connected. And now what we're going to do is we're going to go to the online mode. So the online config mode, basically. Now it's in green color. So once we press it, it will go to the red color. Okay, now we already entered to the online config mode. As you can see, the one turned to the green color and it's showing that it is connected. Now we are ready to test our first tutorial whereby we want to toggle the LED. For that, just go to the GPIOs 1-bit, just double-click on that. And here, for the output, we are not going to concern about the input, we are just concerned about the output. So what's happened is that when you double-click, it will turn to true. When you double-click again, it becomes false. So while pressing that one, the LED will toggle accordingly. Alright, so that's about the tutorial for today. In our next tutorial, we shall do something very more interesting on using the CODESYS as well. So until then, see you next time in our next tutorial. Bye-bye.